Hey there, it's Anonymous T, where we spill the tea anonymously. Hello, 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 everyone. Hello, YouTubers. Hope you guys are all having an amazing day today, sending good vibes, sending positivity, sending good energy, and sending blessings to each and every single one of you. To all the new subscribers, welcome. To all of you who've been rocking with me, thank you so much for continuing to come back and continuing to support me. I greatly, greatly appreciate it. So we are talking about Beyoncé and why she skips these Black Award shows, you guys. So, if you guys have been living under a rock, the last night was, I believe, night one of the NAACP Image Awards, and Beyoncé won a ton of awards again, right? Shocker. She was already named in 2021 the most awarded ever Image Award winner, I think at the time with over 20 Image Awards from the NAACP. And the last time she showed up was a couple of years ago, and that was because she had won Entertainer of the Year and Jay-Z won a President's Award. But outside of that, she rarely attends the NAACP Awards, right? And it's the same thing with the BET Awards. She rarely attends that, right? For a while, she was like easing her way of not attending by like sneaking in performances or sending a YouTube performance to play for the audience at the BET Awards. Now she just doesn't go all together, but it's guaranteed basically that she and her daughter, Blue Ivy, will win an award and not show up. But I'm doing this video because Beyoncé makes such a big deal about this album of the year nonsense at the Grammys that she was willing to have a wardrobe malfunction, get stuck in LA traffic for, and even have a wardrobe change at the Grammys after she accepted one of the other awards that she won that night just for the chance of her name being called to win album of the year, you guys. And I just need to understand why Beyoncé is putting the Grammys, is putting the Oscars, is putting the Emmys on these pedestals as if I win the best category out of these award shows, that is going to mean more to me than all of the other gazillion awards that I have. And basically, BET and the NAACP are treated like the stepchild, you guys. And she didn't even bother to do a video this time. The BET Awards, you guys, that were, I believe, a couple weeks ago or so, right after the Grammys, Beyoncé won a BET Award and did a video for them, but has not done a video for the BET Awards and the NAACP Awards, you guys. Just flat out ignores them all together, you guys. But we'll have every year a post-Grammy party or a post-Grammy dinner. Every year we'll have a post-Oscars party, right? Ever since, right? And this was before even the second Oscar nomination happened. They were having these Oscar parties, right? But why are we putting these award shows on pedestals and these album of the year, these best of awards on a pedestal that typically do not go to Black celebrities and Black artists? And why are we putting so much weight and onus on that particular award and not being appreciative and not being grateful for the awards that you continue to get, for the award shows that you do not even show up to? I don't even remember the last time you went to a Soul Train Awards. It's just really unfortunate, you guys. Meanwhile, the likes of Zendaya and Bruno Mars, they'll always show up, right? They're always going to show up. They're not looking at, you know, this situation to where, oh, because it's the NAACP or, oh, because it's the BET Awards, like, I can't go to that. Oh, no, right? But these are the same platforms. These are the same award shows that were hyping you up from the inception of the early part of your career. So to completely just ignore them and do this disservice and rack up all these awards, not acknowledge them, not attend these award shows unless you are getting a big honoree at the BET Awards or at the NAACP Image Awards, is a slap in the face. The next time we'll see Beyonce at the BET Awards is if there's going to be a tribute announced for her. And you know that's going to piss the people off, especially with the number of legends who have yet to be honored, you guys. But BET will do that just so that they can get the Beehive to tune in, just so that they can get the ratings, right? They'll pull some foolishness like that, right? But it's just sad that, again, there's still so many who are, you know, have this mentality that, you know, only certain things matter, right? Only certain acknowledgments matter. And as a result of that, you abandon and ignore the people who've been riding with you from the beginning when you weren't an A-lister at the time, when you were trying to get your bearings as a, you know, person, a part of a group, when you were trying to get yourself out there initially as a solo artist, when you were trying to build yourself up to that A-list status. You were still being honored by these Black award shows, and to completely abandon them unless they are giving you some big honoree is a slap in the face. It's an absolute joke. Meanwhile, you will show up year after year to the Grammys to lose Album of the Year. Because the fact that you believe in your heart of hearts that your peers are actually going to vote for you to win is laughable in itself as well. When it's pretty clear they don't see it for you. But it's just unfortunate, you guys. It's just unfortunate, and it really sucks that even with all of this happening, like, we saw all the cameras on Beyonce during the Grammys, and the NAACP doesn't say, you know what, thanks but no thanks. Thanks but no thanks, but we're not going to do this, right? Why should we keep awarding somebody who doesn't even want to show up and acknowledge us? Why do we keep giving out these awards when we can argue some of these years, some of these categories, there actually probably was a more deserving winner that would have gladly showed up to the Image Awards, or probably was there at the Image Awards hoping that they could win, and they lost to Beyonce. Right? And it's just, and it's the thing, like, it's not taking in a way, anything away from the accomplishments that Beyonce has done, but it's kind of this elitist attitude to where basically the BET Awards and the NAACP Image Awards don't matter unless you're getting an Entertainer of the Year Award, unless you're getting a President's Award, unless you are getting some sort of tribute for your career. Right? Some type of icon or lifetime achievement award or whatever, right? But you will show up late to the Grammys just for a chance to win Album of the Year. You will have a dressing change for the Grammys just in case they call your name to win Album of the Year, and you can accept your Album of the Year award in a different dress that you wore an hour ago. And then have a Grammy award after party slash dinner to, you know, celebrate in hopes that this was going to be the year that you won Album of the Year. Like, it's just getting out of hand. It's just getting ridiculous, you guys. At what point is there going to be acknowledgement of everything that the Soul Train Awards, the NAACP Image Awards, and the BET Awards have done for you? Meanwhile, you are fine to attend the Grammys and the Oscars and sit there and lose the big awards year after year. Make it make sense. Make it make sense, you guys. So there's that. So that's why I just laugh when people have anointed Beyonce as the best Black entertainer ever, when I know for a fact that, you know, some of these legends would never miss these award shows and would attend in hopes that they would win. And the irony in all of this, the biggest irony in all of this, is these are the same award shows where a lot of the Black categories were not even being televised at the time. That artists, that they had to fight for these categories to be televised, you guys, because for a long time they weren't televised. Just like Jay-Z, a lot of the rap categories, they were never televised, so Jay-Z was boycotting the Grammys, only to show up to them, and then claimed to boycott the Grammys because he went for 0 for 8, and said, you know, and called them out on the 8 bleep song, only to still attend the Grammys, even after all of that. Right? I don't know if it's pride. I don't know if it's like a true belief that you think truly one day you're going to get this award, But the disrespect to the BET Awards, the Soul Train Awards, and the NAACP Awards has to be called out. Like, enough is enough. Like, it shouldn't be, oh, I'm only going to attend if I'm getting a President's Award or Entertainer of the Year Award or a tribute, or I'm going to send in a YouTube performance, right? Like, it's too much. It's too much, right? But you'll show up late. You'll wait in LA traffic just to have an opportunity at the Grammys, just to have an opportunity to win an Oscar. And it just speaks for itself of just how lopsided this is, that you'll do anything to have, you know, whether it's an EGOT or whether it's to win that album of the year from that Grammy committee, who is not going to vote for it because they already basically said that you and your fan base feel too entitled, that just because of who you are and everything else and all of your accomplishments, that it should just automatically be given to you at this point, and that's not how the committee votes. But overall, it's just sad that the BET Awards, the NAACP Image Awards, and Soul Train Awards continue to take a hit. And this is the thing, what happens when you lead by example. Because if you notice, a lot of other A-listers don't show up to these award shows now. Unless they're getting a big award too, right? Unless they're getting a big honoree. And so that's the part of it as well, right? Because Beyoncé's been in this game so long, and she, like, you know, barely talks to anybody. But, like, she doesn't show up to these award shows except for if it's the Grammys. If it's the Grammys, she'll send in a video to the Brit Awards. She'll attend the Oscars if she's nominated. Like, all of these things. She will do all of these things, but will tell BET, NAACP, and Soul Train Awards, unless she's getting a big honoree, thanks, but no thanks. And so, it is just unfortunate, you guys. So, there is that. So, let me know what you guys think. Again, I have a second channel that I am going to be, that is launched. I'm going to be uploading videos to. It's called Anonymous Tea Podcast. It'll still be me and everything else. But we're going to talk more so about news, money-making strategies, sports, just a lot of cool stuff that I really can't talk about on this channel because it's more focused on, obviously, celebrity, reality TV, gossip, and things of that nature, right? So just something a little bit more along the lines of some other things. Oh, and also true crime. Couldn't forget about true crime, right? So I will put that link. It'll also be in my description box, and I will also pin a comment for you guys to subscribe to that for those of you who are interested. And please, of course, do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this video. Hit the notification bell so you're notified the moment I post some content on this channel. And with that being said, I'll talk to you guys again very soon.